Good evening, everyone. Jewel here with the J7409 Weather Channel with your tropical update. I've been waiting for the Euro to update. It updated about 5 minutes ago, so I'm going to have fresh information for you guys on everything that I have gone over today. As we look at this from the National Hurricane Center, you can see over here, this was yellow this morning. Now it is orange. Well, what does all that mean? In the western Gulf of Mexico, it's disturbed thunderstorms is what it is. It's just an area of disturbed weather. It's located over the southeastern Bahamas. Now it is forecast to move into the Gulf of Mexico by early next week, where a broad area of low pressure could form. Thereafter, some slow development of the system is possible, and a tropical depression could form as it moves westward and approaches the western Gulf of Mexico coastline by the middle of the week. Now, in 2 days, it's nothing. In 4 days, or 7 days, I should say, it's up to 40%. Earlier, it was up to 30%, so it has moved up some, and I think it will form into something, maybe a tropical depression. We'll have to wait and see, but I've told you folks over here on these coastlines from Louisiana and all around Texas, you need to have your stuff ready. You know how these things seem to, when they get close to a line, kind of ramp up these days? That's what I'm afraid of. I don't think it'll get too horribly bad, but it could get a little on the side. You need to make sure you got your things done. I'll put it that way. Then we come over here. We're going to have to watch this disturbance number 3 like a hawk. Now, it's another area of low pressure, and it could form in a day or so from an elongated trough of low pressure located several hundred miles to the east-southeast of the Lesser Antilles. Now, some slow development of this system will be possible over the weekend, and I think it will try to do something into early next week as it moves generally west-northwestward at around 10 to 15 miles per hour across the Lesser Antilles and into the northeastern Caribbean Sea. 10% chance in 2 days, 30% now, in 7 days. Now, it's all across the Antilles, Puerto Rico, Dominican Republic. I've been talking about this system too. It has changed from what it looked like earlier today. Earlier today, it looked like it was going to go up around, bring rain and some gusty winds, but it would still be like a tropical depression across all the islands, Puerto Rico, Dominican Republic. Still could get some of that, and it looked like earlier during the day around the Turks and the Caicos, they might even have a Category 1 hurricane. But it doesn't look like that now. So stick around. I'm going to show you all this. Then we've got to come over here to disturbance number 2. It's still this elongated trough of low pressure halfway between the Cabo Verde Islands and the Lesser Antilles. It's got disorganized showers and thunderstorms, and the conditions are marginally conducive for some further development, but a tropical depression still could form during the day or so while it moves west-northwest around 10 to 15 miles per hour. But the wind shear is going to get it, folks. I'm just telling you, don't worry about disturbance number 2 as of right now at all, because the upper level winds are forecast to become unfavorable for development after it gets up to what it can get before it gets to any land areas. It's 40% 2 days and 7 days. Now, this one in the red, I'm not too worried about this one either. It's showers and thunderstorms, and it has some signs of some organization. It's in association with this broad area of low pressure. It's a few hundred miles west of the Cabo Verde Islands. Environmental conditions appear generally favorable for additional development of this system, and a tropical depression is likely to form over the weekend. It's moving west-northwest at about 10 miles per hour. Now, by early next week, the wind shear that's going to get disturbance number 2 is going to get disturbance number 1. the wind shear is just going to make it dissipate over time, okay? By early next week, the upper level winds over the system are forecast to increase, and further development is not expected. So it might show up like something big time that's going to happen, but it's not. Just everybody prepare, because I'm going to show you something down the road that's coming off the coast of Africa. And when it comes off the coast of Africa, it could already be a hurricane or pretty close one. So don't go anywhere. Before I get going any further, everybody on the West Coast, Hilary is a Category 4. We're going to check out the West Coast in a moment. So, got to take one area at a time. So, this is the Atlantic and the Gulf of Mexico. I have this set for tomorrow afternoon around 3 p.m. You can see tropical wave coming through down around the Lesser Antilles. Your wind should only be maybe in the 30 to 35 degree gust of winds. Nothing you cannot handle. You get a little rain out of it. Same thing going on for Puerto Rico and up around the Eastern Dominican Republic. This includes the Bahama Islands and the Turks and the Caicos. Over here, you see, we have a high pressure. Over here is another system. Do not worry about this one. We're going to hop ahead in time a little bit and see how these things progress. Now we're up to Sunday afternoon. You can see this is moving on up here. Nothing big time going on with it. Trying to get a little vorticity with circulation, but it's no big deal right now. And this has already moved across. And the majority of the higher wind gusts, which maybe in the 40s, let's see, 36, that's the wind gust, has already passed the island areas and is mostly south of Puerto Rico. But over here, you can see how those little particles are moving. They're trying to get together over here. Now, this system, I told you it was going to hop across Florida, and there it is, but it's nothing to worry about right now. So we'll move up in time some. Let's get up to Monday evening around 7 p.m. We have a low forming out here in the Caribbean, as you can see right in here. With this low moving on up, it shouldn't bother anybody, but you see what's going on here. You can see right in here, we do have some wind that's coming down. Now, National Hurricane Center saying by the middle of the week, right now, we're looking at Monday evening around 7 p.m. So we'll move up to around 8 p.m. Tuesday. This low is still a low right here, bringing gusty winds over in portions of the Dominican Republic and the Turks and the Caicos. Still nothing that you can't handle or worry about. Let's move this map here some, and let's check this out. We'll put up some so you can see exactly. This have a little something going on with it. Let me take off the pressure gradient so you can see a little better. We'll make it a little bigger for you guys here in Texas, right around Corpus Christi. Now, these winds, let's see what some of these winds are looking like. 44 mile per hour wind gust. Doesn't mean it's going to blow like that forever, but I want you to notice something. All the way over to Loreto, you guys are going to get gusty winds too. You can see where the center is below you. The center, really not a center, it's not a center, but what's trying to form a center of this system is way down here. So, this is Tuesday around 8 p.m. I would suggest when something gets this close, you know how things go up. That's why I'm going on and on about this. I'm not saying it's going to. I do think, though, these winds, once again, let's see what they are right quick. 45 mile per hour winds. Let's turn on the pressure gradient. The pressure's kind of fairly high in it, okay, as of right now. It could change. It could change. I'm just saying. You need to make sure you got whatever you need together. Now we'll hop up to Wednesday afternoon. You can see it's moved on through. Everything's looking fine. But yes, Texas, down south of Houston, down around Corpus Christi, going all the way down, you guys are going to know what's going on. Now this is Wednesday. We want to go back again over here. I told you. Remember, we're in this area. When this little system that tries to make up, it's still just a a very strong tropical depression trying to turn, or tropical wave trying to turn into a tropical depression. The winds here, 39 miles per hour, but there's no center of circulation, no vorticity going on right now. So let's just move up in time and see what happens. We'll move up here so all the island people, you can see what's going on over in Jamaica. We'll hit up to Thursday evening around 9, and then look at there, look at there. It tries to do something. Now, this is going to be a tricky system, folks, and we're going to have to watch this because it's moving up, and now it is really trying to get itself together. The wind in it, though, is 41 miles per hour, so this could become a tropical storm before all is said and done. But this is kind of far out, okay? It's going to change. It's changed from the way it was this morning. This morning, when it was up right around in here, it looked like it was maybe a Category 1 hurricane. Well, that's changed now. But pay attention to it. Also, I want to come over, and I'll make this smaller in a moment, but look what comes off the coast of Africa late Wednesday. Right over here. Now, this little sucker's going to be something to deal with. 69 mile per hour winds, and it's barely off the coast of Africa. It hasn't showed up yet at the National Hurricane Center. I guess they're really waiting a long time to see what happens with it. Let's bring the map down to size some. We'll put it over here, and now you can see this here. And you can see this here. So we'll move up to Friday evening around 9 p.m. See how this is moving backwards again? And everybody in Puerto Rico and the upper portion of the island chain is going, oh no, well, just hold on. We're going to see what happens. But look at this right here. It does nothing but strengthen. 94 mile per hour winds, like I said. When it does come off the coast, it's going to be a hurricane almost when it comes off. So we really need to watch this sucker over here. Now, by Saturday evening around 9 p.m., this begins to lose some of its circulation. Okay? And it begins to move off. Still got some winds in it, but this sucker's still tracking over to the west. And as we move up to Sunday, as far as we can go, then this starts to move back up. Now, when I put on the pressure gradient, you can see it is a low and it is a strong tropical wave over here. Right now, this barometric pressure is unbelievable. It will make you hurt. 29.26 winds in it, 112 miles per hour, and that's probably not the highest winds at this time. Now, this particular system right here, the one that I pointed out, that was in the yellow. I said we had to watch it. We still need to watch it. I think what's going to happen. See, here's a big high right here. We got a low over here and a trough coming up here. That is a low. This is what's saving us. However, though, over in Bermuda, you might get hit by some very tropical weather or a tropical depression before all is said and done. And this particular system, on the latest run of the GFS, has it totally different coming up here and going straight up into Florida. But I don't think it's going to do that. I think it's going to do this. Over on the GFS, I've got this set for Tuesday, like I showed you on the Euro. It does have it right here, trying to form a little bit. So they're kind of in agreement there. I'm just saying, I think this could turn into a tropical depression with no problem. Whether it gets a little stronger, we just got to wait and see. But right now, I think it could turn into a tropical depression. We'll have to wait and see. Either way, it's going to be bringing gusty winds and rain right down in the southern portion of Texas. Now, I told you this system right here. And then we got another one down in here. I want you to watch and see what happens here over on the GFS. Now, here's the one we're watching going up, like up another one. Okay? Now, the GFS has that system that I said was around the Turks and the Caicos Island and Dominican Republic. It's got it way over here. And look, it brings it right up, covering the entire state, with the exception of the panhandle of Florida. And it also has it moving up the coastline of Georgia, covering South Carolina coastlines and North Carolina coastlines before it ever goes out to sea. So, I don't know if this is going to happen or not. This is far out now. This goes all the way up to September. And these storms now, I'm not messing with them. I'm not going to go but so far. But this is something we are going to have to watch. Back over at the Euro, this is for Sunday the 27th. As far as we could go out a while ago, we got low right here. That's the remnants of the low that's coming up in the Gulf. It's going to move on down. This system, though, is really blowing my mind. Okay, now remember how I've told you guys the GFS measure winds much higher up above in the atmosphere than the Euro does. Well, the Euro is showing this system right here. We're going to just flip over, same time, same everything, to GFS. Boom, the GFS has nothing, but it does have a system here. It's got the remnants of what was over in here, brought it down around, and brought it back up. 28.82. We're going to keep our eyes on it. It's all I can say for right now. We'll have to see what happens, but I really have all my eggs in a basket over here right now. Let's check out something about Hurricane Hilary. Hurricane Hilary. Well, the map's not right. Let's get the map right. Okay, now map's right. I want to point out something to you, okay? Yesterday morning, the winds were 85 miles per hour. Now look at this. 12 hours later, the winds were 145 miles per hour. Okay, it's a Cat 4. It's Cat 4. My point is, it didn't take but 12 hours from it going to a Cat 1 to a Cat 4. So therefore, when I talk about the Gulf of Mexico, it may be just a low pressure. It may form into a tropical depression, not a tropical storm. But these things, the closer they get to you, it seems to be over the years, it hasn't changed. They ramp up. Now, Hilary should be a category 4 tomorrow, but the wind should come down just a little bit to around 132 miles per hour. And she is going to be a Cat 2 when she hits land. And you're going to have sustained winds of 98 miles per hour. Maybe a little bit more, maybe a little bit less. But all of you people need to prepare. Look, when it gets up around close to the Los Angeles area, after it's gone through land, the wind's still going to be sustained at 52 miles per hour by Monday. And I'm going to show you guys over in portions of Nevada, portions of Arizona, some of you could get 8 inches of rain. Here is Hilary over in the eastern Pacific. The winds are 145, pressure 939 millibars. For all of the mariners out to sea, it's located at 18.2 north, 111.8 west. It's moving northwest at 10 miles per hour. We also have something else out in the Pacific. Okay, disturbance number one, it's broad area low pressure, could form off the coast of southern Mexico early next week, and gradual development of this system is possible thereafter while it's moving toward the west northwest or northwest, just about in the same way Hilary is moving. Now, generally, it's going to be parallel to the coast of southern and southwestern Mexico. 2 days, no chance. 7 days, 30% chance. Straight from the National Hurricane Center, here's the tracking map for Hurricane Hilary. You can see she is going to remain major right on up until Sunday morning when she turns into a Category 2 hurricane. in this red area, you are under a hurricane warning. The pink is a hurricane watch. The yellow, all around here and up in here around Southern California, that's a tropical storm watch. And a blue area down, and here is a tropical storm warning. For Hurricane Hilary, you can see all of the watches and warnings right up in here. Hurricane warning, Baja California Peninsula, all the way to Punta Eugenia. Hurricane watch, you can see is going on. Tropical storm watch, warnings and watches all the way, as you can see in these areas. This goes all the way to Los Angeles County line, okay, to Catalina Island, tropical storm watch. Now, what we really need to check out on this page, I'll put these watches and warnings up. If you want to know more about them and read them all in description, just click show more to take you to the description box. I'll have it all posted there for you. Rainfall in Hilary. It's going to produce 3 to 6 inches of rain, with isolated maximum amounts of 10 inches across portions of Baja California Peninsula through Sunday night. Flash flooding, locally significant, will be possible. Heavy rain in association with Hilary is expected to impact southwestern United States all the way through next Wednesday, peaking on Sunday and Monday. Rain of 3 to 6 inches with isolated amounts of 10 inches are expected across portions of Southern California and Southern Nevada. Rare and dangerous flash flooding is going to be possible. Elsewhere across portions of the western United States, rainfall totals 1 to 3 inches are expected. Now, let me tell you what. Now, I know Nevada had flooding earlier in the season, but they hadn't had any in a while. All of these places that's been dry for so long, when all of this rain comes down, it's not going to soak up in the ground. It's going to roll around off the ground. It's going to cause flooding. So please be aware of this, and please be prepared for it, okay? So far as the winds go, they're going to be expected within the hurricane warning area by Saturday night, and possible within the hurricane watch area by early Sunday. Tropical storm conditions are expected with the warning area late today and are possible within the watch area in Mexico on Saturday and in Southern California beginning Sunday. Storm surge, it's very likely, and it will cause coastal flooding along with all of this rain along the western Baja California Peninsula of Mexico, near where the center passes, the coast, and the areas of onshore winds or east of the center of Hilary make landfall, the surge will be accompanied by very large and destructive waves. Folks, don't take this lightly. I know about it. I've lived through it. I've had these waves at the top of my house when they come in a hurricane before. Large swells generated by Hilary will affect portions of the coast of southwestern Mexico and Baja California Peninsula over the next day. And of course, you're going to have rip currents with it. So folks out there, I'm not trying to scare you. I'm just trying to make you aware. Right now, make sure you got everything you need. And once the weather starts, stay put until it's over. And please listen to your local forecast, your local weathermen, or your local law enforcement agencies if they do come around your areas. This is a Category 4 now. It's going to hit you with some pretty good winds when it hits land. I would not be surprised if not 100 miles per hour. Maybe a little less, maybe a little more. Flash flooding, if you're in this red around Las Vegas, even maybe Los Angeles, San Diego, Yuma, all these areas here, see how this has changed overnight too? Look, I'm telling you, if you're in any of these areas or live anywhere within these areas, please make preparations now because you have a great chance of flooding to happen. The yellow's nothing to let go of either. That goes all the way to Bakersfield, moving right on up, as you can see, and all around to Cedar City over in Salt Lake City. Just stays a little bit to the west of Phoenix. But all of these areas, you got a chance of it too. But I'm telling you, if you're in this purple or red, please prepare for it. Okay, this is going to wrap it up right now. Around the border, the coastline of Louisiana, and the entire coastline of Florida. Or not Florida, listen to me, Texas. I'm used to saying Florida. The coastline of Texas, especially down around Corpus Christi, that area right in there, you guys really need to pay attention. Big time. Now, when we come to this system, the Euro and the GFS are totally out of sync. They are not matching whatsoever, but I think for the most part, it's going to maybe affect the Turks and the Caicos a little bit. Not a big bad hurricane, not a tropical storm on the edge, but I think it'll be a strong tropical depression at that time. It should then move on up this way and then get pulled on out. This one and this one, not too worried about. And one that's not showing up, that's coming off the coast of Africa now, or not, it's not coming off right, it will be soon next week. I'm really concerned about this one. When it gets off the coast, it's going to already be almost a hurricane, and within 12 hours become one. That's what it's looking like. Where it's going to go, nobody knows. And I'm still going to watch this one real well, too, because GFS has it going up Florida. The whole state, just about, with the exception of the Panhandle, then moving up the coast of Georgia, South Carolina, and North Carolina. The Euro does not. It has it right here like I'm showing you now as it comes up here, makes up, comes back around, and then goes back out. So that's what it's looking like, folks. Hey, thank you for spending your time with me. I've gone over everything I know of today, trying to put this together for you. It is the season to be ready for whatever may come your way. Hey, thanks for watching, and please share this information. This is important information for the East Coast, the Gulf of Mexico, and the Eastern Pacific. If you've got anybody that lives in these areas, call them, check on them, make sure they're all right, especially on the West Coast with Hurricane Hilary. Thank you for your donations. Thank you for watching my videos and everything you do for me, folks. I love you tremendously. Have a good evening, a safe evening, and a blessed evening, and peace, love, and kindness to all. Thanks for watching.